Good morning, friends. Is the screen visible to everyone?
Yes, yes ma'am.
Actually, I'm not much more familiar with this pentaplet, so you must somewhat cooperate with me so that actually whenever I come to write down it in neat language, so it will be good. Actually, my handwriting is not so much bad as it is looking here. Okay. So we'll repeat the theorem that we have seen in the last lecture in short, so that you can understand how we have to derive that derivation. Okay, Lagrange's formulation. So how we have derived Lagrange's formulation? Actually, we have to start with D'Alembert's principle. What the D'Alembert's principle tells you? So what is the D'Alembert's principle? It is nothing but summation over I. Fi minus pi bar dot in bracket, and here it is delta ri is equals to zero. Okay. So what is the D'Alembert's principle? The sum of the total given force and effective forces and the total virtual work done or displacement is equals to zero. Okay. What is the D'Alembert's principle? It is the applied forces Fi and equal and opposite effective forces are given in such a way that the system of a particle moves in such a way that the total virtual work done by the applied and effective forces is zero. Total virtual work done by the applied and effective forces are equal to zero. That this is applied force and this is effective force, Pi bar dot delta Ri is equals to zero. Okay, this was our equation number two. Actually, what is our equation number one? Let me rename this as equation two. So what is our equation one? The equation one is nothing but Ri is equals to Ri of Q1, Q2 and up to so on Qn of T is equals is nothing but our equation number one. Okay, so this we have seen. What we have to see in the next is we have to find out what is the value of delta Ri. Okay, that we have already find out what is the value of delta Ri, which is nothing but summation over j dou Ri by dou Qj into delta Qj. This is whatever delta Ri that we have derived. Okay, so how we have derived this value of delta Ri? Just we have to find out from equation 1. What is our equation 1? Ri is equals to Ri of Q1, Q2 up to Qn. That is, the general and the Cartesian coordinate can be written in terms of one another. That is what a transformation equation. To find out this, let me evaluate in detail. So what will be the derivative? For that, I will write down dou Ri by dou Q1 into delta Q1 plus, what is the next term? Dou Ri by dou Q2 into delta Q2 plus up to so on. We have to work it for all, and the last one is dou Ri by dou T into delta T, but delta T is very small because if virtual displacement is very small, the related time will be smaller, so this term we have equated to zero. Okay, so combining all these terms, what I can write is it is in the form of summation over j dou Ri by dou Qj into delta Qj. Okay, is it okay with this?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Let me go for the next one. That means what is the next part? We have to just find out what is P. P is nothing but our, everyone knowing about P, P is nothing but mass into velocity. Okay, so this I can write for a single particle, Pi is equals to Mi into Vi. So what I can write is about Pi bar dot. So before writing Pi bar dot, let me write down Vi in terms of Ri. Okay, so what is the velocity? It is nothing but rate of change of a position vector. So that I can write it as Mi into Ri dot. ri bar dot or ri dot. So what will be the value of pi bar dot? Because we have to again take a differentiation of this term. As mass is a constant, we can take outside. So there we have to take a derivative of ri again with respect to t. So what is the resultant? Mass is a constant, so it will be ri double dot. Right? Is the idea clear up to this? Now we have to put up those values in our equation 2. Okay. Let me go for the equation 2. What we can write is, so here we have to keep fi as it is, right? So we have the summation over I fi minus pi. Instead of pi, we have to write mi into ri double dot. Okay. What is the value of this delta ri we have found is summation over j dou ri by dou qj into delta qj, right? Which is equated to 0. This is our equation number 2. We have just put up the values of pi and delta ri. Okay. What you have to do in the next step? This summation over I and j we can take outside because both are running with the same summation. So we have to just multiply these terms. Fi dou ri by dou qj. Okay, next is delta qj minus, what is the next term? This mi as it is, ri dot double dot as it is. So we can write here summation also. This summation over I and j both. What we have the next term is dou ri by dou qj into delta qj is equals to 0. So what we have to do now, we know the value of this term, summation over j dou ri by dou qj. That was our value of qj that we have seen. That is nothing but our component of a generalized force. As we have seen the generalized candidate, we should see what is generalized displacement, generalized force, generalized velocity, right? So value of this we have substituted. So what we remain with us is, actually here it should be I. So replacing I and j, we can write this is I and this is j. Value of this is nothing but qj, because if we run the summation over I, then only this is fi dou ri by dou qj. So value of this is nothing but qj that we have substituted this summation over j as it is, and delta qj is also as it is. Okay, because j is a summation here, j we have taken outside because j is on delta qj also. Okay, so hence value of this term we have substituted as qj minus. Right, now what we have to do, we have to find out adjustment for this term. Okay, for what we have done the adjustment for this term, we will write down this as it is. So the term will be as it is equal to 0. Now we have to do an adjustment for this term. I think I have to rub this. So so what we are saying, we have to write down the value of ri double dot. No, so for that what we have done is we have the equation, so we have written d by dt of ri dot into dou ri by dou qj. Okay. Okay, so value of this we have to find out. Is equal to 0. So after finding the value of this, we have to put up the value of ri double dot d by dt of ri dot dou ri by dou qj. So how to find out the derivative of this term? We will first find out derivative of ri dot. So what will be the derivative of ri double dot? It is ri double dot dou ri by dou qj as it is, right? Mine plus, what is the next term? Ri dot as it is. What is the derivative of this term? As we have to find out a derivative of this term, we can write it is d by dt of dou ri by dou qj, okay, which is equal to nothing but our value of this term. Sorry, this is not equal to 0.
Kuch students join nahi ho pa rahe.
Why?
Haan ma'am. Problem hota hai tana join hota.
Me automatic joining aahe na ithe. Kon hai?
Can you? 4-5 students hai.
Madam, mula pan hai.
Haan, wait. एडमिट विचार झाले असतील आता 4-5 ऍड झाले. व्हॉट वी हॅव टू डू नाव, वी हॅव टू राईट डाऊन द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ this is our term. Next term, that is ri double dot dou ri by dou qj is nothing but equals to I think initially it was 31, after you told it is 36 now. I hope your friends have been joined.
Nahi madam azun
नाही केलेत का अजून?
नाही मॅडम.
व्हॉट इज अ प्रॉब्लेम? ऍक्च्युली आय एम नॉट रिस्ट्रिक्टेड एनी वन बिकॉज वी आर शेअरिंग इट टू युअर अवर गुगल क्लासरूम. सो इट इज ऑटोमॅटिक ऍडेड. नाउ नीड टू
आता झालं.
ठीक. Let me start. So ri double dot is equal to what we can write is d by dt of ri dot dou ri by dou qj minus ri dot d by dt of dou ri by dou qj. Okay, so value of this term we have to substitute in our that we have found. Okay. So in this way, we have to just substitute that value in above equation so that we can write it as summation over j, that is nothing but our qj delta qj it is equals to what we have the value is we have just written the value of that term, so that is nothing but summation over j this term as it is mi into value of this above term, okay, that we can write in the whole bracket as it is that term into delta qj. Okay, so this is what our equation number 7 that I will give you on your okay, so value of this term we have substituted here this bracket. Okay, so after that what we have to do, we have to find out the value of d by dt of dou ri by dou qj. Even we have to find out dou ri by dou qj ri dot, all the values that we need from equation number 7. वी डोंट बॉदर अबाउट दिस टर्म वी हैव टू वर्क फॉर दिस टर्म दिस होल टर्म ओके सो फॉर दैट लेट मी स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट टर्म व्हाट वी हैव आवर इक्वेशन वन इज नथिंग बट Ri is equals to Ri of Q1, Q2 up to so on Qn of T, sorry, Qn and T. So we have to now find out the value of Ri dot because we need from equation 7 the in this bracket we need Ri dot dou Ri by dou Qj even we need d by dt of dou Ri by dou Qj. So for that first we will start with Ri dot okay that is nothing but dRi by dt that is we have to find out the derivative of the above term with respect to t so what will be the derivative of above term with respect to t that I can write it as it is a chain rule Ri is a function of q q is a function of t why q is a function of t because we have told the generalized coordinate are also depending on time t okay because there are how many types of constraint holonomic non holonomic scleronomic and trionomic so time may be the consideration so what will be the derivative that we can write it as dou ri by dou q1 right next is dou q sorry dq1 by dt correct dq1 by dt plus what is the next term dou ri by dou q2 dq2 by dt plus up to so on we have to write down up to n term what is the last term we will get it is dou ri by dou t and next is dt by dt that will be equal to 1 so this whole term now I can write in the form of summation can I write in the form of summation from 1 to n okay so for that let me write down that in the form of a summation This equation I will write in the form of summation. Okay. That is Ri dot is equals to. Summation over j to ri by dou qj into qj dot okay q1 dot q2 dot up to so on qn dot plus what is the next term dou ri by dou t so this term we have obtained this is our equation number 8 okay so from equation 7 we have found the value of ri dot next we have to find out dou ri by dou qj right What will be the value of dou ri by dou qj? Let me write down here only. Okay, so what we have to find out from the next term that is dou ri by dou qj. So let me write down the value of dou ri by dou qj. Okay. So that is dou ri by dou qj is equal to how to find out dou ri by dou qj now? Or you can find out d by dt of dou ri by dou qj directly also. Yes, tell me how to find out dou ri by dou qj.
Equation 1, differentiate with respect to qj.
We have to differentiate equation 1 with respect to qj. Next, what is the next term we need here? Dou ri by dou qj. That is d by dt of dou ri by dou qj. Right? So, we have to just find out the derivative of this term. Okay. What we need next term? let me write down the derivative. Can I write down directly? कसा येणार आहे डेरिव्हेटिव्ह आहे झोपलेत का सगळे ओके Let us go with this term. What we have here, ri dot. Okay. What we need the next term is, let me write down the value of dou ri dot by dou qj dot. What is the value of dou ri dot by dou qj dot? Because already we have found the values. Dou ri dot by dou qj dot is equal to, what is the value of dou ri dot by dou qj dot? We have to work for our equation number 8. Okay. Ri dot with respect to qj dot. This is our equation. We have to differentiate this with respect to qj dot. In the last lecture, I have told you these are nothing but our the functions like x and y. If we are having the f is a function of simply x, then the derivative with respect to y will be zero. Okay. So in the very similar way, if ri dot is a function of qj dot, then only we can find out the derivative. At that time, this term will be treated as a constant. So let me write down this term as it is, dou ri by dou qj, right? So next, if I am going to differentiate this with respect to qj dot with respect to qj dot, kay yenar aithe? 1, correct? Dou ri by dou t, whether there is any term here in the second part of our equation 8, qj dot kute disse ka tumhala aithe? Equation 8 madhe, second part madhe?
Nahi madam.
So what will be the derivative? It will be 0. So I can write plus 0. Again, this summation, if you are going to evaluate, so what will be the summation r1 with respect ri with respect to q1 into q1 dot with respect to q1 dot. Next is ri with respect to q2, q2 dot with respect to q2 dot. So in the very similar way, every summation term will be evaluated. So what I get the finally is this equation, dou ri dot by dou qj dot is equals to dou ri by dou qj. So from this seventh equation, this bracket is here only. Ri dot we have already found, dou ri by dou qj is nothing but dou ri dot by dou qj dot. So we have found first two terms. So what is the remaining thing we have to find out? Dou ri by dou qj dot and d by dt of this term. Okay. So if we are going to find out these terms from equations, and then finally I will write down, because this summation we have to run once again, and let me write down the value of the next term that we have to find out is dou ri dot with respect to dou qj is equals to, as qj is already we have taken, so we have to differentiate ri dot with respect to some another variable, that is summation over, instead of j it is k, that is dou 2 ri by dou qk, and dou qj already we have, into qk dot plus ri by dou t dou qj. Okay. So in the very similar way, after getting these equations, we can have equation number 12 that we have seen in the last lecture. Okay. So after that, we have to just do a substitution that we have seen in the last lecture. So hence, after some substitutions and adjustment, we are getting the equation that is nothing but the final equation we are getting is d by dt of dou t by dou qj minus dou t by dou qj, here it is qj dot, is equals to capital qj, and that is what our required equations of Lagrange's equation of a motion. So qj is equals to d by dt of dou t by dou qj dot minus dou t by dou qj. After doing some adjustment, we'll get this equation, and this is called a Lagrange's equations of motion. Okay. Now let us go for the some cases. What are the particular cases? So for that particular cases, what we need is particular cases means what? Conservative system. So whatever we are going to discuss about the Lagrange's formulation, now we will discuss about the conservative system. What is the meaning of conservative system? Conservative system means what? The forces are constant. Okay. So if forces are constant, we have seen one theorem, that is force Fi can be written as some gradient of some function V. What is it? This function is nothing but potential energy. So we can write it is dou Vi by dou Ri minus of this term. Okay. So now whatever the Lagrange's equation we have seen, this equation we have to work for a conservative system. Okay. Now we know that we know Qj is equal to summation over I Fi dou Ri by dou Qj. Okay. Now we have to substitute the value of Fi. Whatever the term Fi we have here, that is minus of summation over I dou Vi by dou Ri into dou Ri by dou Qj as it is. We have just substituted the value of Fi from this term. Okay, this dou Ri will be just, we can do this chain rule and then we can write summation over I dou Vi by dou Qj. Don't say that dou Ri get cancelled. It is not a term so that we can cancel. So it is nothing but your chain rule. Okay. So now we can write this summation over I inside. So what will be the resultant? Dou by dou Qj of summation over I Vi, which is equals to, what is the value of summation over I Vi? Vi is the potential energy of ith particle. So what will be the total potential energy? That we can write it as capital V. Okay. So value of Qj we have found. So what is our equation? We have found just now for Lagrange's equations of motion, we have found Qj is equal to, what was our equation? D by dt of dou t by dou Qj dot minus dou t by dou Qj. Now what is the value of Qj we have found from this equation is dou V by dou Qj. Now here value of Qj I will substitute here, capital dou V by dou Qj is equal to d by dt of dou t by dou Qj dot minus dou t by dou Qj. Okay. So now there is one question, that is we have seen potential energy is a function of generalized coordinate. Just now we have found this potential energy V. We have written here dou V by dou Qj is nothing but value of Qj. Now actually since potential energy is a function of generalized coordinate only, it is not a function of generalized velocity. Why it is not a function of generalized velocity? Because whenever you are going to apply the force, there will be a displacement. But in case of conservative system, force is constant. If force is constant, there will not be any change in velocity. Barabar. Because if you are going with a constant force, agar aap ek constant speed se ja rahe ho, ek constant, yeah, to velocity aapka constant hoga. Obviously, if velocity is constant, if you are going to differentiate with that term, it will be equal to zero. So can I write dou V by dou Qj dot is equal to zero? Right? Derivative of potential energy with respect to Qj dot. What is Qj dot? It is a generalized velocity, will be equal to zero. But this is true only in the case of a conservative system. What is the meaning of conservative system? That is forces are constant. Okay. So hence we can write now here this equation. Here it is Qj dot. So can I write this as d by dt of dou t by dou Qj dot minus dou V by dou Qj dot. Can I write here this term? Because value of this term is zero. Minus what we have again here? Minus this, I can take it dou t by dou Qj this term I can take here, this with the negative sign. So this negative already we have taken outside. So what is the term we have remaining? Let me write down this as it is with negative sign. Now actually this is with negative sign. So this will be now negative dou v by dou qj. This negative term after coming here it will be positive, so minus minus become plus. Okay, so finally this will be equal to zero. Now let me write down this as d by dt of dou by dou qj dot, what is the term here remaining, t minus v, right, minus the next term dou by dou qj, what is the term remaining in the bracket, t minus v. Can I write like this? Because the rule of derivative tells us u plus v, derivative of u plus v and derivative of u minus v, we can write like this, dou by dou qj dot outside and derivative of the term t minus v, here is also t minus v. Now what the Lagrange's has done, he has renamed value of this term t minus v by his name itself, the initial of his name, that is the value of this term he has renamed as capital L. Okay, so what is a Lagrangian function? L is Lagrangian function, which is nothing but t minus v, and hence we can find out the final equation as, what is a new equation in case of conservative system we will obtain is d by dt of dou L by dou qj dot, after substituting the value of L is equals to t minus v, we will get it is dou L by dou qj is equal to zero. Adhicha equation kaya hota apla? General equation d by dt of dou t by dou qj dot minus dou t by dou qj is equals to capital Qj. But after finding the value of Qj from our conservative system and then finding the potential energy is not a function of generalized velocity, because if the force is constant, velocity is constant. So if you are going to differentiate with that term, obviously the term will be equal to zero. This is a general case and this is a case in case of a conservative system. Okay, any doubt up to this? हॅलो झोपलेत का सगळे? वाय आय एम आस्किंग बिकॉज नो वन इज रिस्पॉन्सिंग. डोंट फील बॅड बिकॉज समटाइम्स स्टुडंट डू वन थिंग दॅट दे आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ गुगल मीट. आफ्टर स्टार्टिंग अ गुगल मीट व्हॉट दे डू, जस्ट कीप इट समवेअर एल्स अँड गो समवेअर एल्स, जस्ट लाईक दे आर जस्ट अटेंडिंग द लेक्चर. बिकॉज वेन आय टेल यू to leave the class or to leave the Google Meet, many students are as it is only, which means that they are simply starting that Google Meet and go somewhere else, right? Have you understood this? काय करतात? So let me go for the next case, that is non-conservative. Okay, let me start with the next case, that is non-conservative system. Now in the conservative system, what was the case? Potential energy is not a function of a generalized velocity. Why this is so? Because the constant force, the velocity is constant. So if there is no change in velocity, if you are going to differentiate potential energy with respect to the qj dot, okay, what will be the resultant? It is not a function of in case of conservative system, it is not a function of a generalized velocity. Okay, so in case of non-conservative system, we have to work. Okay, so for that, let me write down the equation. In general, we obtain for a Lagrangian system, Qj is equals to, we have found d by dt of dou t by dou qj dot minus dou t by dou qj. This equation we have formed. remember this equation is very important because very similar equation we are going to see in the second chapter, variational principle. That chapter is very important for your SETNET examinations. Okay, this equation is also important because the next all the example about the simple pendulum, spherical pendulum, all the example we are going to solve with this equation only. Okay, we know Lagrange's equations of motion. So this equation we already know. Now, as in the last case, conservative system, I have told you that potential energy is not a function of generalized velocity, hence the derivative is zero. If some of the function is not involving qj dot, what will be the derivative? Agar v mein qj dot ki term hi nahi hai, to uska derivative with respect to qj dot kya aayega? Zero aayega, right? Just like if f is a function of simply y, so what will be the derivative with respect to x? It is zero. So in case of conservative system, v is not a function of qj dot, v is not a function of a generalized velocity. But now in case of non-conservative system, it is a function of a generalized velocity. So the same equation now we can write in terms of a potential energy. So this same equation I can write qj is equal to d by dt of dou v by dou qj dot minus dou v by dou qj, right? Because if you see here, this t is any function we can write. Okay, so here also we in case of non-conservative system we have written this equation. Okay, so after having these two equation, qj is same, like so we can say if left hand side is same, we can equate this term. After equating this term, what I get is d by dt of dou t by dou qj dot. ओके, ये इक्वेशन हमने डिराइव किया था ना, यहाँ पे टी का वैल्यू हमने सब्सटीट्यूट किया था, कुछ एडजस्टमेंट करके टी हमने क्या फाइंड आउट किया था, समेशन ओवर आई 1/2 एम आई वी आई स्क्वायर. ओके, सो इन द वेरी सिमिलर वे इन केस ऑफ नॉन कंजर्वेटिव सिस्टम वी कैन राइट इंस्टेड ऑफ टी द काइनेटिक एनर्जी कैन बी रिप्लेस बाय पोटेंशियल एनर्जी. वाई दिस इज सो? बिकॉज इन द नॉन कंजर्वेटिव सिस्टम वी कैन हैव क्यू जे इज इक्वल टू दिस टर्म. In the case of conservative system, we have found the value of qj. Kya value aaya tha qj ka? Is equals to minus of dou v by dou qj. Yahi value aaya tha na? So actually this value of qj is in case of conservative system. And this is the value of qj in case of non-conservative system. So now we have to just equate this term. This is dou t by dou qj is equals to d by dt of dou v by dou qj dot minus dou v by dou qj. Okay, now we can take the term which are with d by dt. If I take common, d by dt of dou t by dou qj minus dou v by dou qj dot, there is also dot, this is the term with the dot, is equals to what are the term? This term I can take here, it is dou t by dou qj minus dou v by dou qj. So now again we can do the thing. What we can do is d by dt as it is. Next derivative is also common, qj dot. So what are the term remaining? T minus v as it is equal to dou by dou qj as it is. What are the term inside the bracket? T minus v. So next, what is the value of t minus v? Lagrangian given the value of t minus v by his in that is uska in naam ka jo initial hai usi se wo l ka value hai. So qj dot, this is nothing but capital L minus, now this term I can write dou by dou qj of L of t minus v is L equal to zero. So what do you get from this? That is the Lagrange's equation in case of conservative as well as in case of non-conservative system, it is same. Conservative में भी यही equation आया था ना, t minus v को हमने L substitute किया था. In case of conservative as well as in case of non-conservative system, Lagrange's equations are same. Okay, is there any doubt for this? See, whenever you, I am asking you a doubt, please have any question, you can ask, because if you are going to ask a question, then only other people may be also having the same doubt, that will be clear, no? Okay. If you are having a doubt, you can ask. Otherwise, we'll go for the next case, that is partially conservative system. Ahead ka doubts?
No, madam.
Okay. No doubt it is somewhat a boring subject because you have come from mathematics background whole third year. You have studied mathematics. You will be bored with this. I know, but we have to cope up with this. We have to derive these derivations. Okay. So let us go for the next one, that is partially conservative system. First we have seen conservative system. Next we have seen non-conservative. In both cases, we are getting the same Lagrange's equation. But now we will see the partially conservative system. Okay, partially conservative system. That means it will be consisting of both conservative as well as non-conservative forces. Okay, conservative force means constant force, as well as it will contain non-conservative force, that is, which is not constant force. Okay, sometime we'll have the effect of air, sometime we'll have the effect of rain. This type of effect may occur in case of partially conservative. Okay. So we can have, when the forces acting on the system consist of conservative as well as non-conservative forces, we can have dissipative forces. Dissipative forces means what? The forces which try to destroy the motion. Just like if we are, suppose we are traveling on a bike, why I am taking mostly this example, because you are familiar with this example. Everyone has traveled with the bike or anything else. So whenever you travel with the bike, suppose the wind, agar hawa bahut zyada tez hai, so obviously there will be some problem while taking your bike. As well as agar aap suppose barish ho rahi hai, so at that time also it is difficult to derive the bike, right? So that's why the type of a forces which try to destroy the motion, aap jab bike travel kar rahe, bike ko ride kar rahe, tabhi aap barish ya fir hawa zor se chalta hai, so obviously there is some problem. That means that is nothing but our resistance or limitations that is going to destroy your motion, right? Sometime it is completely not possible to derive your bike in the monsoon season. So at that time you are going to stop your motion. No, that is what you are going to, just stop your bike. So which means that it has completely destroyed your motion. Okay, so these type of a forces called a dissipative forces. That is what a non-conservative forces. जो कभी भी constant नहीं रहते, आप सब हमेशा बारिश आएगी इसका कोई guarantee नहीं ना. Sometime it will come. So this type of forces we called as a dissipative forces. Okay, so the forces which try to destroy the motion are called a dissipative forces. Okay, so now let us go with the component of a generalized force Qj is given by, what is the value of component of a generalized force Qj? We have found that is nothing but summation over I Fi dou Ri by dou Qj. Now, as we are in case of partially conservative, as I told you that there are two type of forces here. What are the two type of forces? The conservative force and the dissipative force. So instead of having Fi itself, we have the two type of forces. This I treated into two terms, that is conservative force as well as non-conservative. Non-conservative means what? This force is always not constant. It may be sometime happening or it is not happening. Okay, air forces, rain forces, or anything else, this which they try to destroy your motion is called a dissipative force. Okay, now we have to write down this term. After this, what we have to find out? We have to find out the value of this terms. Okay, let me write down. This will be nothing but summation over I Fi dou Ri by dou Qj चलो इट शुड बी आ रहा है ना, इट शुड इज आ रहा है। डो आर आई बाय डो क्यू जे प्लस नेक्स्ट टर्म इज समेशन ओवर आई एफ आई दिस आर आई एफ आई डी दैट इज डिसिपेटिव फोर्सेस इन टू डो आर आई बाय डो क्यू जे। ओके सो नाउ लेट मी फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ द फोर्स एफ आई। एफ आई इज इक्वल टू वॉट विल बी एफ आई, इट इज नथिंग बट माइनस ऑफ डेल वी आई। Why we are taking minus of del vi? Because in case of partially conservative, there is conservative as well as non-conservative force. So in case of conservative force, we know the theorem that is forces can be written in terms of a gradient of some function. What is that some function? Is potential energy. So which is nothing but minus of dou vi by dou ri. While writing this statement, you have to write down the statement of a theorem. What the theorem we are going to use? Necessary and sufficient condition for the conservative system. Okay. Next, what we have to find out the value of a QJ dot. Okay, QJD. Okay, this is nothing but your QJD. Now, what is the value of QJ? We have summation over I Fi dou Ri by dou QJ. In general, this is nothing but Fid dou Ri by dou QJ. That I can rename as QJD. That is component of the generalized force, but in case of dissipative forces. Okay, so hence the what will be the value of equation one? This is nothing but your QJD. No, this is in general, and this is the value of our QJD because here we have added the value of a term, a conservative forces as well as non-conservative forces. So what will be the value of QJD now is equals to value of this Fi we have found is it is nothing but minus of summation over I dou Vi by dou Ri. This is a term as it is into dou Ri by dou Qj plus what is the next term we have? It is nothing but summation over I Fi d into dou Ri by dou Qj. Okay. So this term we have obtained. Now, what will be the value of this? As dou ri are the same. So we can write this as is equal to minus of this summation, if I take inside, minus summation over I as it is into dou ri as they by using chain rule, we can write it is dou qj plus what is the next term we are remaining? Summation over I fid into dou ri by dou qj. Okay, so finally we can write this as minus of dou capital V. Vi is a potential energy of ith particle. Sum of all the potential energy is a potential energy of whole system. Dou qj plus, right? So what is the next term we have? The value of this term, I can write it as Qj d dash. Already Qj d we have used, so that's why I am using Qj d dash. Okay, now we have to find out the what is our Lagrange's equation of a motion. What is our Lagrange's equation of motion in case of partially conserved? So for that, what we must know is we know that. What we know that? Okay, why we are writing we know that? Can anyone tell me the reason? Yes, we know that asa ka lihto apan. I know that, that's why I'm writing, or to the examiner also you can say you know that. Lihu shakto na asa. Hello, aikta aitna mala?
Yes ma'am.
Then why we are writing we know that? एक्झाम मध्ये सपोज तुम्ही आय नो दॅट किंवा यू नो दॅट असं लिहिलं तर चालणार नाही का? आर यू गेटिंग माय क्वेश्चन?
सगळ्यांना माहित असतं म्हणून सांगितलं मॅडम.
हां, दॅट्स व्हाय वी आर रायटिंग. इफ आय राईट आय नो दॅट, सो व्हॉट एक्झामिनर विल टेल यू इफ यू आर नोईंग, सो इट इज ओके आय डोंट नो. यू से यू नो दैट देन व्हाट यू व्हाट वी आर नोइंग बराबर ना आई नो दैट वी नो दैट ओके सो हियर व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू जे डी वी हैव टू सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस क्यू जे डी विल सब्स्टिट्यूट इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ओके सो दिस इज अवर इक्वेशन इन केस ऑफ लैग्रेंजेस जनरल इक्वेशन ऑफ अ जनरल फॉर्मुलेशन सो हियर वी हैव रिटन क्यू जे डी बिकॉज वी आर डिस्कसिंग इन केस ऑफ पार्शियली कंजर्वेटिव So this term here as it is equals to minus dou v by dou qj plus qj d dash. Okay. So we can now rename this equation and then we can write this term we can take here. So what will be the term here? D by dt of. The term we have is dou t by dou qj dot. Right, minus dou v by dou qj dot. Why I can write this term minus dou v by dou qj dot? Because we are having conservative as well as non-conservative. For conservative case, what we have studied, potential energy is not a function of generalized velocity. So what will be the value of this term is zero minus this term I will keep as it is minus dou t by dou qj. Again, this minus term, it comes here, it will be positive. It will be dou v by dou qj plus what is the term remaining qj d dash okay so hence again what you have to do t minus v is l again here if you take minus outside it is again t minus v so that we can write l and finally we can write the new equation as so what will be the new equation after substituting the value of लास्ट स्टेप व्हाट वी हैव इज ओके लेट मी राइट डाउन डी बाय डी टी ऑफ डो टी बाय डो क्यू जे माइनस डी डो टी बाय डो हियर इट इज क्यू जे डॉट हियर इट इज क्यू जे इज इक्वल्स टू क्यू जे डी इथेपर्यंत कळालं का हे क्यू जे डी च्या व्हॅल्यू आपण ऑलरेडी काढलेलं व्हॉट इज द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ क्यू जे डी वी हॅव फाउंड इज मायनस ऑफ डो वी बाय डो क्यू जे प्लस क्यू जे डी डॅश वी हॅव फाउंड अप टू दिस राईट सो लेट मी राईट डाऊन हिअर डी बाय डी टी ऑफ डो टी बाय डो क्यू जे डॉट मायनस डो टी बाय डो क्यू जे इज इट क्लिअर अप टू दिस
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So what I have done, as we are in the case of conservative as well as non-conservative, that means partially conservative. So in case of conservative system, what we have done, dou t by dou qj dot as it is minus of dou v by dou qj dot. Why the value of dou v by dou qj dot we have written here? Because potential energy is not a function of generalized velocity in case of conservative. And in the partially, we have both the cases, conservative as well as non-conservative. So we can add this term, dou v by dou qj dot. Hyacha value kay yenar aahe? Zero che yenar aahe. Zero add kara, subtract kara, kay yenar aahe? Resultant zero che yenar aahe. So instead of having simply this term, we have added one, we have subtracted one term, minus zero. Ite minus zero lihla tar kay honar aahe? Kay pan nahi. Barobar aahe? Any doubt now? Hello? Is there any doubt if I am adding or subtracting zero? This is a term which is zero, no? Because in case of partially conservative, we have conservative as well as non-conservative force. So this is non-conservative. This is what a conservative minus. What is the next term? Dou t by dou qj. Now this minus, if I take here, it is dou v by dou qj plus qj d dash. Okay, so this is zero. We can add or subtract zero from the any equation. So next, what is the next term? D by dou by dou qj dot. I can take common t minus v. Next term, this minus if I take common, so this dou t by dou qj dot. So this t minus v again in the bracket, right? Here it is minus. So this term we have taken plus. So actually here it should be equality, na? This equality qj d dash, right? So this t minus v, now we have to just substitute this t minus v as l. Here also t minus v, I am going to substitute l. Okay, so in case of conservative and non-conservative system, we have obtained a same equation. But in case of partially conservative system, what will be the equation? D by dt of dou by dou qj dot l, dou minus dou l by dou qj is equal to qj d dash. कंजर्वेटिव नॉन कंजर्वेटिव मध्ये इथे इक्वेशन मध्ये काय आलं होतं इक्वल टू झिरो बट पार्शियली कंजर्वेटिव मध्ये काय आहे इथे क्यूजे डी डॅश ओके इज देर एनी डाउट
नो मॅम
ओके लेट मी एंड द लेक्चर विल यू विल हॅव द नेक्स्ट वन आय होप नाव द आयडिया इज क्लिअर See, what I am not familiar with pen tablet just now, so that's why it will be somewhat difficult. After some practice, writing will be more improved. Okay, thank you. You can leave the meeting and go for the next one.
Ma'am, mera.